Hey yo, I'm back, but nobody was asking where I've been. Cause when idols get confronted, they say you cannot win. But I'm comforted by knowing through Christ, I'm God's friend. And by his grace, I will never change directions like top spin. I'm locked in, a God-centered verse in your face. He'll satisfy your thirst when you taste his mercy and grace. We live in a time of analysts, trying to find the catalyst for all kinds of savageness. Stats, crimes, and averages, but never mind the blasphemous lines of an activist strategist who maligns the divine protagonist. Who you think it's all about? The star of the show is Jesus Christ, the Zardin. You already know. It's not wise to defy him. Will slice through your pride and life's suicide without Christ crucified. Yeah, he's the lion and the lamb at the same time. Trying to fight him, you can't be of the same mind. So since we know him, let's adore him. He deserves it. At one time, our culture had reverence for him, but over time, I guess they quit being impressed. Maybe because they saw him as a hippie in a dress. But read Revelation 1, you'll get a different picture. He's risen. Listen to his description in the scriptures. Golden sash around his chest, high claim of sire, feet like burnished bronze, eyes flame of fire, voice louder than Niagara Falls, face brighter than the sun, giant staggers and falls, at his feet as though dead, to see him's to no dread, and Jesus so glad so we can go spread, the fame of the king is the name that we sing, he tamed death's sting and he claims everything, like that Abraham Kuyper quote, save his fam, thank him man, he ignites our hope, praise the lamb, Christ is dope, it amazes me to this day that God uses me, especially when I reflect on who I used to be, hip-hop idolater, moralistic legalist, new age agnostic, Afrocentric hedonist. I was all about the sex, trying to flex, Dos Effects, Malcolm X, counting checks. I hated the God of the Bible, wouldn't stand to listen. I saw Christianity as the white man's religion, used to oppress, to abuse and distress, keep them glued to the pews and refuse to progress. I didn't know the Bible showed true faith in Africa. You can't blame Jesus for crusades and massacres. Jesus is beautiful, he reigns and he's sovereign, regardless of the actions of those who claim to follow him. I focus on faith believers, but not on myself. I was breathing God's air, believing God on the shelf. When it came to saving myself, this kid was missing tons. My reality check bounced, insufficient funds. God brought me to a point where I came to realize the gospel of Jesus Christ, that's where the real lies. The only antidote to fight Satan's real lies. The scales were removed, now I see with real eyes. One thing I've seen that's not so pristine since the presidential election of 2016. A focus on politics controls the whole populace. Exposed so much rottenness, trolls so anonymous. But this is my hypothesis, I can say it with confidence. In light of the apocalypse, politics is a pile of bricks. So why are we seeing biblical truth get sacrificed on the altar of political groups? The Lord Jesus Christ is not a Democrat or Republican. He is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords who shed his blood for sin. Not only that, he died to make us one, in union with the church, Spirit, Father, and the Son. Therefore, we have been united over grace. So how the church gonna be divided over race? Something's amiss. As we twist in this abyss, amidst the drift and shift, I've witnessed this. White Christians not resisting viciousness, Black Christians who persist to lift the fist. So let's address the elephant with biblical intelligence. When it comes to indwelling sin, melanin is irrelevant. Christ wasn't European, that's a proper fact. But the quote, why does it matter whether God was black? His blood was red, blood that he shed for men. And if you don't accept the king, you'll be dead in sin forever. That's the bottom line, we're running out of time. For the persecuted church, every day is column. What happened to the urgency, the human emergency? Have we lost our fervency, failing to look vertically? Only God in heaven can stop this downward spiral. Our only hope for survival is revival. To spurn being tribal, discern who's our rival. Learn from the Bible and turn from our idols. Lord, we look to thee, our God and our Savior. Cause thou hast a way like Donnie and Layla. Put the nonsense to rest, my God's the best. And he can save anybody, even Kanye West. God rescues foul men, I'll testify then. I know it's true because he saved a wretch like Shai Linne. Yeah, he's giving God praise, some won't lift their voice with him. But if the angels rejoicing, then I'ma rejoice with him. But if it's true that a secular rapper's leaving his sin, will that make Christian rappers start talking Jesus again? What? I better stop there before it gets too hot here. So let me make this the last thing that I share. We represent the Lord Jesus Christ, no apology. Stay tuned for LT3 Sociology. 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 Sociology.